Good morning, everyone. This is Brother Lloyd, also known as Tube 87. And I'm going to do this quick video before I go to bed. It's 9:30 in the morning. I just got off work a couple hours ago. But the Father has impressed upon me to put this message out here because someone's going through it right now and they need to see this and get a better understanding of what you're dealing with so that it can bring some peace to you as you go through this trial or this test. And that is a change. Some of you are going through a change because you are becoming or trying to draw closer to the Father in His Word and understand what His Word is teaching us and live your life according to that. But what you're finding out is that there are plenty of people right now coming against you, and most of them are those closest to you, your husband or your wife, your mother, father, sister, brother. Those who are closest to you are the ones who are going to cause you the most pain as you go through these trials, and they're causing this because they know you for who you were, and this change that you're going through is something contrary to what they know about you, and they don't believe that this is really you. So the enemy is using them to try and tempt you and put you through these trials to get the old you back, because that's what they all love and that's what they have all embraced. They are having a hard time dealing with this new you because it's going to require them to change. See, not only are you changing, when you go through something like this, you cause others around you to change. And that's the way the power of the Father works. So the longer you hold the course, the tougher some of these trials may get, because the enemy is going to fight harder and harder through those who love you the most. Go with me to Micah first, Micah 7. And I'm going to read Micah 7, verse 6. It reads, it says, "For the son dishonoreth the father, the daughter riseth up against the mother, the daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. A man's enemies are those of his own house." And go with me to Matthew 10. We're going to start with verse 35. Matthew 10 and verse 35, 36. It reads, it says, "For I am come to set a man at variance against his father, and the daughter against her mother, and the daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. And a man's foes shall be they of his own household." Look, you're going to go through it, the Father's word tells us. And he's talking about those closest to us. Forget the people you work with, the strangers, those who hardly know you. You can shut them out easy. But your trial is coming through those who are closest to you because they don't want to accept a new you. They love the old you. They love the old wild you, the old you that used to party, the old you that used to hang out and drink and do all these things. They are going to fight you tooth and nail to keep the old you. So what you have to do is stay the course when studying and doing and living the Father's word. Because as you stay the course, they see this change that you're going through or this new person that you're becoming is really you. They see that you're not wavering. The enemy is trying to use them to cause you to waver and slip back and forth. And they'll go, "Oh yeah, we still got the same you. You ain't changed. You're still doing the same old thing." And this is especially true when it comes to trying to keep the Sabbath. Because, see, that's totally contrary to the majority of the world. You're talking Friday at sunset till Saturday at sunset. Do you realize how much goes on Friday evening when people get off work until Saturday night? We're talking picnics, barbecues, birthdays, movie theaters, malls, dinners, partying, all these things. See, there are a lot of people that are used to you doing these types of things, but all of a sudden now they're like, "What? Oh, you just talking. You, that ain't you." And so they're going to tempt you and try you. So you have to start shutting them out. Telephones, locking your door, not answering any of this stuff. You have to show them that you are for real about what you're doing. See, and as long as you stay by the Father's word, He will empower you. He will show them through you. The enemy is going to keep pushing and tempting and trying, and you just have to keep hanging on to the Father and let the power that He gives us through the Holy Spirit fend all that off. And see, after a while, it'll settle down. I'm telling you, been there, done it. When I went through my new change, when I started understanding and studying the Father's word and stop doing certain things, yeah, people came against me. I had a few run-ins with family members or what have you, because it's something brand new to them. So as they see that you're serious, you slowly gain that respect. Now, they may not respect you fully initially, but no one's going to mess with the Father's word when they see that's what it's about. People may whisper behind your back and say, oh, you're fronting, or you're crazy, or you all caught up, or you all getting all religious now and all that mess. But let them. But let them see that you're serious about this change in your life. And after a while, they will start to respect you for respecting the Father. And they will start to wonder. Some of them actually start to wonder, well, what's going on? This new person is you. Now, it takes time. You can't expect people to accept this overnight. Now, for those of you who are married, if it's your husband, if it's your wife, and you're living in the same household, and now you're on different wavelengths, you hang on to the Father. See, because they're watching you, whether you realize it or not. They watch you, and they're trying to see if this is for real. And after a while, they will see this change over you, this peace about you, this different character about you, this love you have for the Father, and all these blessings that the Father is providing for you. And then they will start to become curious, like, well, I might want some of this. They may start asking questions. And so you have to be a shining light, especially when you're married to some of these folks. You have to stand the course and hold a course, and you can promote a change in them through the Holy Spirit by doing what is right, by doing the same thing over and over, being consistent in the Father's word, being consistent in living his word. Because if these people truly love you, they will come on board. You have to go through your trials, go through your tests. Go with me to Matthew 10:21, because I'm going to show you how serious this is. These people who are close to us coming against us. Matthew 10:21, it says, and the brother shall deliver up the brother to death, and the father the child, and the children shall rise up against their own parents and cause them to be put to death. Mark 13:12 reads, it says, now the brother shall betray the brother to death, and the father the son, and children shall rise up against their parents and shall cause them to be put to death. See, before it's all over and done with, this will become more serious, because you will have parents turning in children, children turning in parents, brothers turning in sister, vice versa. People will turn people in to gain favor with those in authority and power. When this world starts to get truly crazy, the only one you're going to be able to trust is the Father and his word, because those who are closest to you who haven't embrace the Father and embrace the lifestyle and all the things that he promote that we should do, they will seek to turn us in. They did this to whom? Our Savior. Go with me to John 13:18 reads, it says, I speak not of you all. I know whom I have chosen, but that the scripture may be fulfilled, he that eateth bread with me hath lifted up his heel against me. See, the Savior was talking about those closest to him, even those who sat and ate with him, family members. They're right there next to you. Go with me to Psalms 41:9. Psalms 41:9 reads, it says, yea, mine own familiar friend in whom I trusted, which did eat of my bread, have lifted up his heel against me. See, once again, he's talking about those closest to him. But then finally, let's go to John 13:18. And it reads, it says, I speak not of you all. I know whom I have chosen, but that the scripture may be fulfilled, he that eateth bread with me have lifted up his heel against me. See, so the fulfilling of scripture is going to be the same for us. Those whom are closest to us, those who sit right next to us and eat with us, those who we love and hug, brother, mother, father, sister, whomever, those closest to us, in the end, some of them will come against us, because they're going to have to deal with the world, and the world will hate us just like they hated him, and they're going to want to get us, and those people who know us best will be the ones turning us in. So, like I said, go through your trials, go through your pain, but be consistent. Let those around you see the sincerity and the love that you truly have for the Father. Whatever it is, go through it. But in the process, you have to stand firm and you have to learn how to shut them out. Let them be upset. Let them be angry. Let them be mad. Let them be whatever. But love will prevail. You keep loving them. You keep praying for them. And those who truly love you, they'll come back. They may never come on board to where you are, but they will gain a new profound respect for you for loving the Lord. And with that being said, remember, the Heavenly Father doesn't call on us to be successful. He calls on us to be faithful. This is Brother Lloyd, 287. I'm out.